Hi students, welcome back to All for C Learning classes. In this session, let us discuss about pole, polar, conjugate points, conjugate lines and inverse points. Actually, this topic is only for MCET and IPE, not for mains and advanced, but it is important. Okay. Now, first we start with pole and polar. Pole and polar. What is the pole? What is the polar? First, we observe the definition of the pole and polar. Let S is equal to 0 be a circle and P be any fixed point in a plane, in the same plane. The polar is the locus of point of intersection of tangents. The polar is the locus of point of intersection of tangents drawn at extremities of the chords passing through fixed point P. The fixed point P is said to be pole of polar. The locus is said to be polar and the fixed point is said to be pole. Now, explanation. Suppose S is equal to 0 is one of the circle. This is one of the circle with the center C. Say it is the circle S is equal to 0 with the center C. P is any point in the same plane. P be the any fixed point in the plane. Say P is one of the fixed point in the plane. The polar is the locus of point of intersection of tangents drawn at extremities of the chords passing through a fixed point. From this fixed point, how many chords are possible to this circle? Infinite number of chords. All of these are chords. Please observe this value. All of these are chords. From a fixed point, we can draw infinite number of chords. Okay. This chord cuts the circle at AB, say, or A1, B1. At this end points, suppose the tangent is drawn at A1, tangent is drawn at B1. These are intersecting at a particular point. The locus of point of intersection of tangents drawn at extremities of the chords is nothing but a polar. This locus is said to be a polar. Similarly, suppose this chord intersects the circle at A2, B2. Okay, then the tangent at this point is in this way. The tangent is in this way. By joining these values, the locus of these values means by joining these values, we get a polar. Suppose this is the tangent. This is the chord A3, B3 or A3, B3. It is in this way. The tangents are at these values are in this way. It is one of the locus. By joining all of these values, we get a line. Thus, that line is said to be a polar. Locus of point of intersection of the tangents drawn at extremities of the chords is said to be a polar. This fixed point P is said to be pole. The fixed point P is said to be pole. This locus is said to be a polar. Very, very, very important. Please write the definition of the pole and polar. Pole and polar. Let S is equal to 0 be a circle and P be any fixed point in a plane. Then the polar is the locus of point of intersection of the tangents drawn at extremities of the chords passing through fixed point P. The fixed point P is said to be pole of polar. The fixed point P is said to be pole of polar. Please draw this diagram. P is the fixed point. Say this value is A1, B1 is one of the chord through this P. The tangents at A1, B1 are intersecting at this point. Take A2, B2 is the another chord passing through P. These are intersecting at this value. By joining all of these points, we get a locus. That locus is said to be a polar. Locus of point of intersection of tangents drawn at extremities of the chords passing through this fixed point. Okay, please note the diagram. Please note the theorem statement. The equation of polar of Px1, Y1 with respect to the circle S is equal to 0 is S1 is equal to 0. The equation of polar of Px1, Y1 with respect to the circle S is equal to 0 is S1 is equal to 0. Already, we discussed the definition of the polar. What is the polar? Polar is the locus of point of intersection of the tangents drawn at extremities of the chords passing through a fixed point. Suppose it is one of the circle. It is one of the circle, given circle S is equal to 0. P x1 comma y1 is any fixed point. Okay. Suppose from P to this circle, we can draw infinite number of chords. Say one of the chord is AB. Say this value is AB or QR. One of the chord is QR. The point of intersection of the tangents at these endpoints is nothing but say this value is A alpha comma beta. The point of intersection of the tangents at endpoints of this Q and R is A. Say this value is alpha beta. Now we find the locus of this alpha beta. This locus is said to be a polar. Now we find the locus of A alpha comma beta. Okay, please note the statement. The equation of polar of P x1 y1 with respect to the circle S is equal to 0 is S1 is equal to 0. Proof. Let S means x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0 be the given circle. And P x1 y1 is the fixed point. Let QR be any chord drawn through P x1 y1 and QR be the any chord. Say this is the fixed point P. QR be the any chord. Okay. Through P. Next. And the tangents at Q and R. Tangents at Q and R meets at A alpha beta. Now, locus of A alpha comma beta is nothing but polar of P x1 y1 with respect to the circle S is equal to 0. Okay. Now we find the locus of this A alpha comma beta. But what is the QR? QR is nothing but suppose P is an exterior point with respect to the circle S is equal to 0 and the tangents are PA comma PB, then AB is nothing but chord of contact of P with respect to the circle S is equal to 0. AB is nothing but chord of contact of P x1 y1 with respect to the circle S is equal to 0. Here QR is nothing but chord of contact of A alpha comma beta with respect to the circle S is equal to 0. So, but QR is chord of contact of A alpha comma beta with respect to the circle S is equal to 0. What is the equation of the chord of contact? S1 is equal to 0. Therefore, equation of the chord of contact is S1 is equal to 0. What is the notation for S1? S1 means XX1 plus YY1 plus G of X plus X1 plus F of Y plus Y1 plus C is equal to 0. Here, X1, Y1 means A. A means alpha beta. So, replace X1, Y1 as alpha beta. Alpha X plus beta Y plus G of X plus alpha plus F of Y plus beta plus C is equal to 0. It is equation number 1. This equation is nothing but equation of the chord of contact QR. But this QR passes through the point P X1, Y1. This line passes through P X1, Y1. But it passes through P X1, Y1. So, substitute the point of P X1, Y1 in equation 1. We get alpha X1 plus beta Y1 plus G of X1 plus alpha plus F of Y1 plus beta plus C is equal to 0. But this QR line passes through PX1, Y1. So, substitute this point in the equation 1, we get this value. Now, we find the locus of alpha beta. To get the locus of X1, comma Y1, the equation can be replaced as X1, comma Y1 can be replaced as XY. Suppose for getting the locus of alpha comma beta, we replace alpha comma beta as x comma y. So, locus of A alpha comma beta is, replace alpha comma beta as x comma y. That means, xx1 plus yy1 plus g of x plus x1 plus f of y plus y1 plus c is equal to 0. It is nothing but s1 is equal to 0. Therefore, equation of the polar is nothing but s1 is equal to 0. Okay, please note this proof and diagram. Next. The equation of the polar of P x1 y1 with respect to the circle S is equal to 0 is S1 is equal to 0. What is the meaning of S1? S1 is equal to 0 means xx1 plus yy1 plus g of x plus x1 plus f of y plus y1 plus c is equal to 0. Okay. xx1 plus yy1 plus g of this value. Suppose we separate x terms, y terms and constant, it can be reduced into xx1 plus g of x. That means x1 plus g of x plus y1 plus f of y plus gx1 plus fy1 plus c is equal to 0. Please observe this equation. It is in the form of ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Ax plus by plus c is equal to 0 means this equation always represents a straight line. It is the first degree linear equation in xy. That means this equation always represents a straight line. That means polar of a any point P with respect to the circle S is equal to 0 is S1 is equal to 0. That polar always represents a straight line. Always represents a straight line. It is in the form of AX plus BY plus C is equal to 0. Okay. Please note these points. Note. The polar of P X1 Y1 with respect to the circle S is equal to 0 is S1 is equal to 0. The polar equation always represents a straight line. In this case, the polar equation always represents a straight line. Please note this statement and this proof also. S1 is equal to 0. That implies xx1 plus yy1 plus this value. It is in the form of ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. Therefore, polar always represents a straight line. Okay. First one is okay. Next, second one. If px1 y1 lies outside of the circle, if px1 y1 lies outside of the circle, then polar meets the circle at two different points. Please note this point. If px1 y1 lies outside of the circle, then polar meets the circle at two different points. In this case, chord of contact of P will be the polar. Chord of contact will be the polar. Please observe this diagram. This is the circle S is equal to 0. C be the center of the circle. PX1, Y1 is any exterior point. Here the point PX1, Y1 lies outside of the circle. Okay. Suppose, what is the definition of the polar? Polar is the locus of point of intersection of tangents drawn at extremities of the chords passing through this fixed point. Say, one of the chord is this value. The tangents at endpoints is this value. This locus is said to be polar. Suppose another chord is in this way. The locus of the point of intersection is in this way. By joining these values, we get a line. Okay. It is a straight line. Already in the case 1, already we proved that value. Suppose the chord is in this way. The locus of point of intersection of the tangents is in this way. By joining this value, this line also passes through this value. Please observe this value. But the point of intersection of the tangents never be lies inside of the circle. This means, in this case, the tangents never intersect inside of the circle. So, in this case, the locus is a straight line, but it is a part of a line, not inside of the circle. This locus is a straight line. But the tangents never be intersecting inside of the circle. So in this case, we use dotted lines. Okay. Please observe this value. This line cuts the circle at this point and also this point. This line cuts the circle at two different points. It is the meaning. Please note this diagram and statement also. If Px1, Y1 lies outside of the circle, then polar meets the circle at two different points. The two points are these values. This is one other point. This is another point. Please draw the diagram. Px1, Y1. It is nothing but polar. It is nothing but polar. Polar cuts the circle at this point and this point. It is the A, it is B. Say the two values are AB. In this case, the equation of the polar is S1 is equal to 0. But what is the chord of contact of PX1, Y1 with respect to the circle S is equal to 0? S1 is equal to 0. Both are identical. In this case, S1 is equal to 0. Polar equation is also S1 is equal to 0. That means chord of contact will be the polar of PX1, Y1 with respect to the circle S is equal to 0. Okay, very, very important. Please note the diagram. Write the second statement and also draw this diagram. It is the polar, it is the pole. Fixed point is pole. Next, third one. If Px1, Y1 lies on the circle, if Px1, Y1 lies on the circle, then polar of P coincides with the tangent at P. Polar of P coincides with tangent at P. Observe this diagram. Suppose it is the circle S is equal to 0 and C be the center of the circle. Here the point PX1, Y1 lies on the circle. Say PX1, Y1 is one of the point on this circle. Okay. What is the definition of the polar? Polar is the locus of point of intersection of tangents drawn at extremities of the chords. How many chords are possible from P? We get infinite number of chords drawn from P to this value. Okay, suppose the one of the tangent at P is this value. P, it is the A, one end point of the chord. So draw this tangent at this value. This value is intersecting on this line. Okay, next, PB is the another tangent, sorry, another chord. At P, the tangent line is same. At B, the tangent line is in this way. These are intersecting on the tangent at P. Please observe this diagram. Suppose this is one of the chord. This is D. Draw the tangent at P. It is a tangent. The tangent at D meets the tangent at P. So the polar is nothing but the equation of the tangent at P. Please observe this diagram. If P x1, y1 lies on the circle, then polar of P coincides with the tangent at P. Polar equation is nothing but tangent. It is the polar or tangent at P x1, y1. Both are coincide, identical. Polar equation is nothing but tangent at P x1, y1. Okay. Please write the note the diagram. Next, fourth point. If P x1, y1 lies inside of the circle, then polar does not meet the circle. If P x1, y1 lies inside of the circle, then polar does not meet the circle. Suppose the circle is in this way. Center of the circle. Suppose P x1, y1 is one of the in point inside of the circle. Say this is one of the chord. From this chord we draw a tangents at end points. These are intersecting at this point. Say another chord. This is the another chord. This is AB. This is DE. These are intersecting at outside. By joining these values we get a locus. Locus is nothing but a straight line. Polar is nothing but a straight line. This line must be lies outside of the circle. Okay. If the point P lies inside of the circle, then polar never meets the circle. Okay. That means the line lies outside of the circle. Please draw this diagram. P, X1, Y1. AB is one of the chord. These are intersecting at this value. Next, D is another chord. These are tangents are intersecting at this value. By joining these values, it is the polar. Polar always lies outside of the circle. That means it never cuts the circle. Very, very important. If P lies inside of the circle, then polar never cuts the circle. If P lies on the circle, polar is nothing but tangent at P. If P lies outside of the circle, polar is nothing but chord of contact. Please observe these three points. Okay, draw the diagram. Next, fourth one. Okay, fourth one. Px1, y1 lies inside of the circle. Polar does not meet the circle. Next, fifth one. If Px1, y1 is the center of the circle, the fixed point coincides with the center of the circle, then polar of P with respect to the circle S is equal to 0 does not exist. Then polar of P with respect to the circle does not exist. Very, 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 very important. Fifth one. Suppose it is the circle S is equal to 0, C be the center. If P is outside or on the circle or inside, and at the same time P coincides with this center of the circle, C is equal to P, then the chord passing through this P is nothing but diameter of the circle. Suppose it is the one of the diameter or chord through P. P is this value. The locus of point of intersection of tangents drawn at these endpoints is nothing but a polar. But the tangents at endpoints of the diameter are always parallel. These never be intersecting. So polar does not exist. So polar does not exist. Very, very, very important point. Please note that point. If Px1, Y1 is the center of the circle, then polar of P with respect to the circle S is equal to 0 does not exist. Does not exist. Please note this diagram. Write the reason. In this case, chord is nothing but a diameter. The tangents at the endpoints of the diameter never be intersecting. Therefore, polar does not exist. Okay. Next, sixth one. Let C be the center of the circle. Let C be the center of the circle. Then polar is always perpendicular to the line CP. Then the polar is always perpendicular to line CP. Here the circle is in this way. It is S is equal to 0 is one of the circle. C is the center of the circle. Say P is one of the point. Here polar is nothing but chord of contact. Polar is nothing but chord of contact. Say these values are tangents. It is the polar equation. It is the polar. Okay. It is the polar. Polar equation and chord of contact are coincide when the point P lies outside of the circle. Okay. Here we can prove that the PC line is perpendicular to polar. Angle between these two values is 90 degrees. That means polar is always perpendicular to line joining center and pole CP. Now in this case, we have to prove that CP perpendicular to polar. Okay, if the two lines are perpendicular, what is the condition? Product of the slopes is equal to minus 1, m1, m2 is equal to minus 1. Here P, x1, y1, center of the circle is equal to minus g, comma minus 1. Okay, what is the slope of PC? PC slope is equal to y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1 means y1 plus f by x1 plus g. Okay, it is the slope of the line CP. What is the equation of the polar? Polar equation is nothing but S1 is equal to 0. XX1 plus YY1 plus G of X plus X1 plus F of Y plus Y1 plus C is equal to 0. Reduce this value into standard form AX plus BY plus C. That means X1 plus G into X plus Y1 plus F into Y plus GX1 plus FY1 plus C is equal to 0. What is the slope of this line? Slope of the polar is equal to minus x1 plus g by y1 plus f. Minus x coefficient by y coefficient. Here, this is the slope m1. It is the slope m2. Now, clearly, m1, m2 is equal to. M1, m2 is equal to cancel this numerator to denominator. Denominator, numerator cancel. That is equal to. Clearly, m1, m2 is equal to minus 1. Therefore, CP is always perpendicular to polar of P with respect to the circle S is equal to 0. Very, very, very important. CP is always perpendicular to the polar of P with respect to the circle S is equal to 0. Okay? Please note the theorem statement. The pole of the line LX plus MY plus N is equal to 0, N not equal to 0 in bracket. With respect to the circle, X square plus Y square is equal to R square is minus r square l by n comma minus r square m by n. In previous case, if the point P is given, P x1 y1 is given, then polar of P with respect to the circle S is equal to 0 is S1 is equal to 0. If pole is given, we find the equation of the polar. In this case, the line equation is given. That means polar is given and we find pole point. Okay, please observe this value. Okay, if point is given, polar equation is S1 is equal to 0. If polar is given, what is the point? It is the theorem. Okay. Proof. Pole of the line LX plus MY plus N is equal to 0. We find this value. We prove this value. Okay. Let PX1, Y1 be the. Let PX1, Y1 be pole of the line. Pole of the line LX plus MY plus N is equal to 0. Say this point is X1, Y1. If the point is given, what is the polar? S1 is equal to 0. Then, equation of polar with respect to the circle x square plus y square minus r square is equal to 0 is S1 is equal to 0. S1 means xx1 plus yy1 minus r square is equal to 0. It is the polar equation. But from the given polar is Lx plus My plus N is equal to 0. But polar equation from the given is Lx plus My plus N is equal to 0. These two are identical. This is a polar. This is a polar. These two are identical. If two lines are identical, what is the condition? A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2. Okay. That means X1 by L is equal to Y1 by M is equal to minus R square by N. That means X1 by L is equal to equating last value. That implies X1 is equal to minus R square L by N comma Y1 is equal to minus R square M by N. Therefore, PX1 Y1 is equal to minus R square L by N comma minus R square M by N. It is the pole. Please observe this value. Required value is this value. Therefore, pole of this line with respect to this value is minus R square L by N comma minus R square M by N. Suppose here N is equal to 0. If N is equal to 0, what is the condition? The pole does not exist. Something by 0 means not defined. Something by 0, not defined. If N is equal to 0, then the pole of that line does not exist. Okay. If N is equal to 0, this line must be passes through origin. Origin is nothing but center of the given circle. The given circle equation is x square plus y square is equal to r square. The center of the circle is 0, 0. In this case, if n is equal to 0, the line passes through origin, that means center of the circle. If the line passes through center of the circle, then pole does not exist. In this case, if n 0, it does not exist. Please observe this point. Very, very, very important point. If the line, given line passes through center of the circle, then the pole of that line does not exist. If the line passes through center, that means it is one of the diameter. That means the pole of the diameter of the given circle does not exist. Very, 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 very important condition. If n is equal to 0, that line passes through center of the circle. If the line passes through center of the circle, pole does not exist. Okay, pole point does not exist. Please note this proof. Next, note point. If the line passes through center of the circle, if the line passes through center of the circle, then pole of the line does not exist. Pole of the line does not exist. Next, pole of the diameter of the circle with respect to the same circle does not exist. These two are very, very, very important points. Pole of diameter of a circle with respect to the same circle does not exist. If the line passes through center of the circle, then pole does not exist. Okay, please note these two points also. Proof and these points. Next note point, let px1, y1 be pole of the line lx plus my plus n is equal to 0 with respect to the circle s is equal to 0. In previous case, the pole of the line lx plus my plus n is equal to 0 with respect to the small circle, that means center is 0, 0, x square plus y square is equal to r square. But here center not equal to 0, the circle is s is equal to 0. Then x1 plus g by l is equal to y1 plus f by m is equal to r square by lg plus mf minus n. This pole satisfies this condition. By using this property, we find x1 comma y1. Direct formula for pole is this value. Suppose in this case also, what is the let p x1 comma y1 be the pole, then what is the equation of the polar? S1 is equal to 0. S1 means xx1 plus yy1 plus g of x plus x1 plus f of y plus y1 plus c is equal to 0. So it can be reduced into x1 plus g of x plus y1 plus f of y plus gx1 plus fy1 plus c is equal to 0. Okay, but from the given line equation is lx plus my plus n is equal to 0. These two are identical, that means a1 by a2 is equal to b1 by b2 is equal to c1 by c2. By using this value, we find x1 comma y1. Okay, please note this formula directly. Please note this point. Let px1 y1 be the pole of the line lx plus my plus n is equal to 0 with respect to the circle s is equal to 0, then x1 plus g by l is equal to y1 plus f by m is equal to r square by lg plus mf minus n. Second one, the pole of the line lx plus my plus n is equal to 0 with respect to the circle s is equal to 0 is, by equating 1 and 3, we get x1 value, that is minus g plus r square l by lg plus mf minus n. By equating second and third values, we get minus f plus r square m by lg plus mf minus n. Suppose center is 0, 0, minus b minus f is equal to 0, 0. That means g can be replaced as 0, f can be replaced as 0. That means 0 plus r square l by minus n, minus r square l by n. Similarly, minus r square m by n. Okay, please note that point. Next. Next, conjugate points. Next one heading, conjugate points. Conjugate points. Suppose it is the circle S is equal to 0. P, Q are two given points. These are said to be conjugate when the polar of P passes through Q and polar of Q passes through P. Please observe this point. Suppose P is one of the points. P x1, y1 is any point. Then its polar is nothing but chord of contact. So this equation is in this way, S1 is equal to 0. Okay, the polar of P x1 y1 is this value. Suppose the polar of P passes through the point Q, that means the Q point lies on the polar of P, then these two points are said to be conjugate points. Then these two points are said to be conjugate points. If the polar of P passes through Q, then polar of Q also passes through P. Polar of Q is nothing but chord of contact. This also passes through this point P. Okay, please note this point. If the polar of P x1 y1 with respect to the circle S is equal to 0 passes through Q x2 comma y2, then the polar of q x2 y2 with respect to the circle s is equal to 0 also passes through p x1 y1, also passes through p x1 y1. In this case the points p comma q are said to be, in this case the points p comma q are said to be conjugate points. Please note this diagram. It is the circle s is equal to 0, p is one of the point, the polar of p, this is the polar of p, polar of p, okay, polar is nothing but cut of contact. Suppose the polar of p passes through q x2 comma y2, then these are simply said to be, these are said to be conjugate points. Similarly, if the polar of q, if the polar of p passes through q, then polar of q also passes through p, okay, if polar of p passes through q, then they are said to be simply conjugate points. Okay, please note the diagram. Polar of q means this, in this way, suppose this is the polar of q. Next, condition for conjugate points, condition for conjugate points, condition for conjugate points. Suppose p x1 comma y1 and q x2 comma y2 are two conjugate points with respect to the circle s is equal to 0. What is the condition? Polar of p x1 comma y1 is s1 is equal to 0. Okay, s1 is equal to 0 means x x1 plus y y1 plus g of x plus x1 plus f of y plus y1 plus c is equal to 0. But this polar of p must be passes through q x2 y2. So q x2 y2 must be lies on this polar, lies on this value. So substitute this point in this equation. That means x y can be replaced as x2 y2. X1 x2 plus y1 y2 plus g of x1 plus x2 plus f of y1 plus y2 plus c is equal to 0. That implies it is nothing but s12 is equal to 0. If the two points p comma q are conjugate with respect to the circle s is equal to 0, what is the condition? S12 is equal to 0. Very, very, very important. Next, please note this point. If the points p x1 comma y1 and q x2 comma y2 are two conjugate points with respect to the circle s is equal to 0, then the condition is, then the condition is s12 is equal to 0. Write the proof. Polar of p x1 y1, polar of p x1 comma y1 with respect to the circle s is equal to 0 is s1 is equal to 0. That implies, please write this value. It is equation number 1. But this polar passes through q x2 y2. But this polar passes through q x2 y2. Substitute the point q x2 comma y2 in equation 1. We get this value. That implies s12 is equal to 0. If the two points are conjugate, then the condition is s12 is equal to 0. Very, very important. Next, conjugate lines, conjugate lines. Suppose s is equal to 0 is one of the circle and l1 is equal to 0 is one of the line, l2 is equal to 0 is another line. Please observe these two lines. L1 is equal to 0 is one of the line, l2 is equal to 0 is another line. If the pole of the line L1 is equal to P and pole of the line L2 is equal to Q, then in this case the two lines are said to be conjugate only when, if the pole of the line 1 must be lies on the pole, must be lies on the polar of L2 line, that means line L2. If the pole of the line L1 is equal to 0 with respect to the circle S is equal to 0 lies on the line L2, the pole of this line with respect to the line L2 is equal to 0, then pole of the line L2 must be lies on the line L1 is equal to 0. In this case, these two lines are said to be conjugate lines. In this case, these two lines are said to be conjugate lines. Pole of the line L1 must be lies on L2 and pole of the line L2 must be lies on the line L1. Here, P, comma, Q are conjugate points. At the same time, these two lines, these two polars are said to be conjugate lines. Okay, please note this point. If the pole of the line L1 is equal to 0, if the pole of the line L1 is equal to 0 with respect to the circle S is equal to 0 lies on the line L2 is equal to 0, then pole of the line L2 is equal to 0 with respect to the circle S is equal to 0 also lies on the line L1 is equal to 0. Please observe this point. Pole of the line L1 must be lies on the L2. Similarly, pole of L2 must be lies on the line L1. In this case, these two lines are said to be conjugate lines. In this case, these two lines L1, L2 are said to be conjugate lines. Said to be conjugate lines. Theorem. If the lines L1x plus M1y plus N1 is equal to 0, comma L2x plus M2y plus N2 is equal to 0 are two conjugate lines with respect to the circle x square plus y square is equal to r square, then r square into L1 L2 plus M1 M2 is equal to n square. It is direct formula. Given circle is small circle, that means center is 0, 0. Please observe this point. Given circle x square plus y square is equal to r square. This is the circle equation. What are the given lines? L1x plus M1y plus N1 is equal to 0 is one of the line. L2x plus M2y plus N2 is equal to 0 is the second line. These two lines are conjugate. What is the meaning of conjugate? The pole of the line, first line, must be lies on the second line. If the line Lx plus My plus N is equal to 0 is given, what is the pole? Pole is nothing but minus R square L by N comma minus R square M by N. So first we find the pole of the line, this line. Okay, now pole of the line L1x plus M1y plus N1 is equal to 0 with respect to the given circle is nothing but minus R square L by N comma minus R square M by N. Here the line is L1x, M1y, N1. L means L1, M means M1. That means minus R square L1 by N1 comma minus R square M1 by N1. It is the pole. But from the given, these two lines are conjugate lines. That means the second line must be passes through this point. Okay. But from the given, or since 1 and 2 are conjugate lines, therefore the point minus R square L1 by N1 comma minus R square L M1 by N1 lies on the line 3. That means second line. Substitute this point in this equation. Then we get L2 into L2 of x means minus R square L1 by N1 plus M2 of minus R square M1 by N1 plus N2 is equal to 0. Okay, by 1 is equal to 0. Here LCM is N1. N1 is the LCM. Minus R square L1 L2 minus R square M1 M2 plus N1 N2 is equal to 0. After cross multiplication, it can be reduced into this value 0. And at the same time, R square is the common term. R square L1 L2 plus M1 M2 is equal to N1 N2. It is the formula. R square into L1 L2 plus M1 M2 is equal to N1 N2. It is N1 N2. R square into L1 L2 plus M1 M2 is equal to N1 N2. If the two lines are conjugate, then what is the condition? R square into L1 L2 plus M1 M2 plus is equal to N1 N2. Please note the proof. Given circle. Now the pole of the line, first line, L1 X plus M1 Y plus N1 Y is equal to 0 is this value. Since the two lines are conjugate. Okay. Second line must be passes through this point. Substitute this point in this equation, we get the condition. In this case, the given circle is, center of the given circle is 0, 0. If the center of the given circle is not equal to origin, 0, 0, then what is the condition? Please note this point. Note, if the lines, L1x plus M1y plus N1 is equal to 0, L2x plus M2y plus N2 is equal to 0 are conjugate lines, with respect to the circle S is equal to 0, then R square into L1 L2 plus M1 M2 is equal to L1G plus M1F minus N1 into L2G plus M2F minus N2. In this case also we find the pole of this value. Pole of the line L1x plus M1y plus N1 is equal to 0 with respect to the circle S is equal to 0. If the center is not equal to 0, pole is minus G plus R square L by LG plus MF minus N comma minus F plus R square M by this value. But these two are conjugate. Second line must be passes through this value. Substitute this point in this equation, we get this value. Okay, please note this value. R square into L1 L2 plus M1 M2 is equal to L1G plus M1F minus N1 into L2G plus M2F minus N2. Okay. Next, inverse points. Inverse points. Suppose S is equal to 0 is one of the circle and P, Q are said to be two inverse points with respect to the circle S is equal to 0, then they satisfy these conditions. Let S is equal to 0 be a circle with the center C and radius R. Two points P, Q are said to be inverse points with respect to the circle S is equal to 0 if C, P, Q are collinear. Center of the circle means C. C, P, Q are collinear. Next, P, Q lies on the same side of the center C and CP into CQ is equal to R square. Simply, inverse points are in this way. Suppose S is equal to 0 is one of the circle. P is any one of the point. P is any point in the plane containing the circle S is equal to 0. Okay, join CP. This is the line CP. Okay, next, what is the polar of P? Polar of P is nothing but S1 is equal to 0. It is the chord of contact. If P lies outside, then polar is nothing but chord of contact. It is the polar of P. Polar of P with respect to the circle S is equal to 0. The point of intersection of the polar of P with respect to the circle S is equal to 0 and the line CP, line joining the center and pole. Okay, line CP. This point of intersection is said to be simply inverse point. Inverse point is the point of intersection of the line CP and polar of P with respect to the circle S is equal to 0. Polar is always perpendicular to this value. It is perpendicular. Please observe this value. If the point P lies outside, then polar cuts the circle at two different points. In this case, P, Q lies on the same side of the circle. C, P, Q are collinear. P, Q lies on the same side of the center C. Okay. Next, CPQ must be collinear. Point of intersection means these, all of these points are collinear. At the same time, CP, find the distance CP and CQ. CQ is nothing but perpendicular distance from C to this value is mod AX1 plus B1 plus C by root over A square plus B square. CP is the distance between two points. After finding the CP and CQ, CP into CQ must be R square. This inverse point satisfies these conditions. Very, very important. At the same time, suppose the point P lies on the circle. The point P lies on the circle. Please observe this value. On the circle, then polar is nothing but tangent at P. CP is this value. In this case, please observe this value. The point of intersection of the polar and line is nothing but same P. That means, in this case, P is equal to Q. The inverse point of P is itself. If the point P lies on the circle, then the inverse point of P is also again P. P is equal to Q. If the point P lies inside of the circle, suppose C is P lies inside of the circle, polar lies outside. Okay, CP line, these are intersecting at Q. Please observe these points. If P lies inside of the circle, then its inverse point must be like, sorry, P lies outside of the circle, its inverse point must be lies inside of the circle. If P lies on the circle, then its inverse point also lies on the same circle. At the same time, these two are equal. Okay, if the point P lies inside of the circle, then its inverse point lies outside of the circle. Please observe these points. Okay, in this case, to find the inverse point of P is nothing but point of intersection of the line CP and polar, or in simply find the equation of polar S1 is equal to 0. This angle is 90 degrees. It is nothing but Q is nothing but foot of the perpendicular from P to this line. Foot of the perpendicular means H minus X1 by A is equal to K minus Y1 by B is equal to minus of AX1 plus B1 plus C by A square plus B square. By using that formula, we find inverse point. Or this is also foot from C. Okay, inverse point of P is nothing but foot of the perpendicular from center of the circle to polar of P. Both are same. This foot is Q, this foot is Q. Okay, foot of the perpendicular from P or from C to the polar of P. Very, very important points. Please note this value. Inverse points. Let S is equal to 0 be a circle with the center C and radius R. Two points P, Q are said to be inverse points with respect to the circle S is equal to 0 if, first one, C, P, Q are collinear. C, P, Q are collinear. Second one, P, Q lies on same side of C. Third one, CP into CQ is equal to R square. It is the first point. Second point, simply write in this way. let px1 comma y1 be the any point in the plane containing the circle s is equal to 0. Then the point of intersection of polar of P, the point of intersection of polar of P with respect to the circle S is equal to 0 and the line CP is said to be inverse point of P. It can be denoted by Q. The point of intersection of polar of P with respect to the circle S is equal to 0 and the line CP is said to be inverse point of P. It can be denoted by Q. Please note this diagram. Here Q is the inverse point of P. It is the polar of P. Polar of P. Okay, please note the diagram. Here Q is simply foot of the perpendicular from P to polar. Q is inverse point. Q is foot of perpendicular from P to polar of P with respect to the circle S is equal to 0. Or Q is the foot of the perpendicular from center C. Foot of the perpendicular from center C to the polar of P with respect to the circle S is equal to 0. Foot from P to the polar or foot from C to this polar is also same Q. Okay. Next, please write note points. Note. First one, if P lies outside of the circle, if P lies outside of the circle, then its inverse point Q lies inside of the same circle. P lies outside, Q lies inside of the circle. If P lies on the circle, then its inverse point Q is equal to P. Both are equal. Third one, if P lies inside of the circle, then its inverse point Q lies outside of the circle. Inverse point Q lies outside of the circle. Okay. Next. Please note the diagrams. Suppose the P is in this way, C is in this way, polar is in this way. So Q lies, if P lies outside, Q lies inside. If P lies on the circle, then polar is same this value. So P is equal to Q. Okay. If P lies inside of the circle, polar outside. That means the line joining this value, these are intersecting at Q. If P lies inside, Q lies outside. If the point P lies inside, polar never cuts the circle. Okay. These are very, very important points. Next, at the same time, please observe these points. Suppose this is the circle, S is equal to 0, P is one of the point, its polar is in this way. What is the inverse point? It is the Q. Please observe this point. The polar of P must be passes through Q. That means P, Q are conjugate points. P, Q must be conjugate. If P, Q are inverse points, they must be conjugate. If the polar of P passes through the point Q, then it is said to be, then the two points are said to be conjugate points. Suppose the point R, it is R. In this case, P, R are conjugate. But P, R are not inverse. Inverse points means the CP line and polar are intersecting at only one point. Every two lines, non-parallel lines are intersecting at only one point. So, inverse of every point is unique value. If P is any point, then inverse of this point is Q. This can be exist in unique way. Okay, please observe this point. Please note this point. Fourth one. If P, Q are two inverse points with respect to the circle S is equal to 0, then they are conjugate with respect to the same circle. But converse need not be true. If the two points are conjugate, they may or may not be inverse points. Okay, please observe this point. If the points are inverse, they must be conjugate. But conjugate points may or may not be inverse points. Converse need not be true. Very, 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 very important point. Okay. आप नेक्स्ट नोट पॉइंट वेरी 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 इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट लेट एल वन कामा एल टू बी लेंथ ऑफ टैंजेंट्स लेट एल वन कामा एल टू बी लेंथ ऑफ द टैंजेंट्स ड्रॉन फ्रॉम टू कॉन्जुगेट पॉइंट्स ए कामा बी टू द सर्किल एस इज ईक्वल जीरो और विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू द सर्किल एस इज ईक्वल जीरो देन ए बी स्क्वेयर इज ईक्वल टू एल वन स्क्वेयर प्लस एल टू स्क्वेयर दट मीन्स द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द टू कॉन्जुगेट पॉइंट्स ए बी इज नथिंग बट अंडर रूट एल वन स्क्वेयर प्लस एल टू स्क्वेयर वेरी 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 इंपॉर्टेंट अंडर रूट एल वन स्क्वेयर प्लस एल टू स्क्वेयर प्लीज ऑब्जर्व दिस वैल्यू एस इज ईक्वल जीरो इज द सर्किल एक्स स्क्वेयर प्लस वाई स्क्वेयर प्लस टू जी एक्स प्लस टू एफ वाई प्लस सी इज ईक्वल जीरो इज वन ऑफ द सर्किल हियर ए एक्स ए बी आर टू कॉन्जुगेट पॉइंट्स लेट ए एक्स वन कामा वाई वन बी एक्स टू कामा वाई टू आर टू कॉन्जुगेट पॉइंट्स टू कॉन्जुगेट पॉइंट्स मीन्स दट मीन्स एस वन टू इज ईक्वल जीरो वाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ एस वन टू एक्स वन एक्स टू प्लस वाई वन वाई टू प्लस g of x1 plus x2 plus f of y1 plus y2 plus c is equal 0. It is the condition, first condition. Okay, if two points are conjugate, then s12 is equal 0. Now we prove that ab square is equal to l1 square plus l2 square. Consider RHS. RHS is equal to l1 square plus l2 square. What is the value of l1? Length of the tangent from a to the circle is said to be length l1. L1 is nothing but, what is the value of L1? Root S11. Length of the tangent from external point to the circle is equal to root S11. L2 is equal to root S22. Okay, that means S11 plus S22. S11 plus S22. Okay, that implies, that is equal to, S11 means X1 square plus Y1 square plus 2GX1 plus 2FY1 plus C plus x2 square plus y2 square plus 2gx2 plus 2fy2 plus c. Okay. Please write this value. x1 square plus x2 square plus y1 square plus y2 square plus 2g of 2gx1 plus 2gx2 means 2g of x1 plus x2 plus 2f of y1 plus y2 plus c means 2c. So, here what is the common term? 2 is the common term. That is equal to x1 square plus x2 square plus y1 square plus y2 square plus 2 of g of x1 plus x2 plus f of y1 plus y2 plus c. But from 1, g of x1 plus x2 plus f of y1 plus y2 is nothing but this can be replaced as minus of x1 x2 y1 y2. This can be replaced as minus x1, x2, minus y1, y2 from 1, since from 1. Replace this value. That means it can be adjusted in this way. X1 square plus x2 square plus y1 square plus y2 square minus 2x1, x2. Then that means x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. It is nothing but AB square. AB square is nothing but distance between two points. So AB square is equal to L1 square plus L2 square. Therefore AB is equal to under root L1 square plus L2 square. Very, very, very important. Please note this proof. Okay?